Hello everybody, my name is Sulit and welcome to the Power Grid. We are going to be playing episode 1 of Firewatch, and it's about a man named Henry who escapes his complicated life to take a job as a fire lookout in the wilderness of Wyoming. Is it Wyoming? Yes, I think it's Wyoming if I read correctly. So stay tuned, let's see what's in store for us. Let's go. Campo Santo presents in cooperation with Panic Inc. Boulder, Colorado, 1975. You see Julia. Hi, Julia. She's about your age, late 20s. Laughing with well-dressed professors and grad students from nearby CU Boulder. You, Henry, are out drinking with your pals. You approach her. Okay, hello. You are drunk. You're pretty. You're pretty, she says coolly. You are not. You're a future hangover. What? You reply confused. Someone should buy you a cheeseburger, she says. She flags down a waiter, and 1 week later, you are Julia's boyfriend. Things are going by pretty quickly. Eight, seven, six, five. I wonder if that has any significance. One, two, three, four. We're in the ground level. Wonder if that has any significance whatsoever. No! Your backpack is gonna fly out of there. You date for over a year. She drives you absolutely nuts. It's great. Why do you put his backpack in the back? That's not a good move. All right, you move in. You share an apartment near the school with a view of the mountains. You two drink beers out on the deck. You drink beer just about anywhere. Life is good. Okay, so good so far. Julia wants to get a dog. Great idea, Julia. There's a scruffy, undersized beagle. Julia's in love. She wants to bring it to her with class. She wants to bring it with her to class. There's also an intimidating but gentle-eyed German shepherd. Nothing bad can happen to Julia while walking this dog. It's badass. Let's go with a badass dog. You adopt Shepherd and name him Mayhem. Mayhem's an excellent dog. He loves wrestling with you in the park and goes with Julia on her runs. Even though he's too big to bring to school, Julia loves him all the same. Mayhem is a friend, child, and pet, all rolled into one. All right, that's what I'm talking about, 1979. You talk out on the deck. It's summer, 9:30 p.m., and the heat still radiates off of the high desert. What do you think about kids, she asks. Kids? They're not very smart or good at much. I'm saying if I have some, with you, a couple little idiots. That would be pretty good. In that case, we should probably get married. Yeah, I would like that, you say. These kids are going to be screwed up enough. It's probably for the best that their parents are hitched. You say she's absolutely right. Let's get to Vegas, baby. Okay. Pick up her backpack? I'm assuming so. Where are we? Fire danger. Oh, it's in the red. prevent forest fires. Okay, fire danger is at an all high today. Thoroughfare Trailhead, Two Forks Region Overview. So there's a map of the trailhead. Do not forget to check in. You're in their country. No fireworks. Warning, this trail is not for inexperienced hikers. Okay. I must have done some hiking in my days, so let's do this. Otherwise, I wouldn't be here. 1980. It's a Thursday night, and Julia is 4 hours late. She doesn't call. You're worried and getting angrier by the minute. She walks in after you've gone to bed. She's not quite drunk, but she says she's been clearly having fun. You fight when she gets between the sheets. You get mad. You call her an inconsiderate asshole. She tells you to go fuck yourself and to be not a baby. You call her selfish. She knows you mean it and it hurt her feelings. Oh, yikes. These two are having a massive argument. 1981. Julia still likes to draw. She draws plants from her research. She draws all the places she goes. She draws you. You pose and flex like He-Man. You look awesome. I would never pick the one on the right. That's... okay, I'll leave that to other people. Okay. Wow. That looks really cool. This is a very visually aesthetic game. During the summers, you and Julia enjoy walking mayhem at night. There's a festival in town. It brings in folks from faraway places. One of them tries to mug you with a knife. Mayhem runs away. May, me, moo, fuck, da-da, dog, Julia yells. She gets flustered and has trouble speaking when she is stressed. You confront the attacker. You scare him away. You reach into your pocket like you've got a gun and threaten to kill him. You manage to scare all three of you. He runs away. Julia asks to take a different path from that day forward. You say okay. You don't want to go that way either. From then on, you walk by the river. 1984. Plans to have kids get waylaid by work. Typical. Julia gets offered a job at Yale. Yale is in Connecticut, 2,000 miles away. It's a great job. Associate department chair. That is a great job. She wants to move. You absolutely do not. Convince her not to take the job. You tell her that this means you two won't have a family. She says that's bullshit. She's totally right. She asks if her taking the job means you won't come with her. You say yes. Again, bullshit. But she decides not to take it. 1985. Julia is asked to leave Boulder on paid leave after having an episode. She lost it on a colleague for borrowing books that were important to her research. She didn't remember she had happily loaned them to him 2 days prior. Oh, what's going on, Julia? She was found crying in the stairwell. You make macaroni and drink wine and try to forget about it. It works. You watch Dallas on TV and sleep together on the couch. Now it looks like after hiking, we have now settled down into our own little campsite here without a tent anywhere. So Henry likes to sleep outdoors, out in the open, just with a sleeping bag. That is brave of you, Henry. Very brave. Let's pick up this journal. Oh God! He-Man, King Beef. What? Mayhem is getting older. He's got silver hair down his back and it slows down at night. You and Julia walk him to the bar to see your friends. It feels like nothing has changed. Julia goes back to the university. Okay, good, so she is no longer on leave. Back to work. 1987. Julia's affliction gets worse. She can't remember things in class. Her research is in shambles. She drives her car to the next town over for no particular reason. She has to be brought home by the police. She's devastated. She's sent home on permanent medical leave. Some days, you get the Julia who calls you a dope and your unborn children little idiots. Other days, you get a stranger. She pulls you into bed to make love. After 5 minutes, she goes into a panic, believing her dad is at the door. Huh? Oh no. You tell her family. They are crushed and begin to make trips to and from their home in Australia to visit her. For a while, your friends come by with little things to brighten the day. She gets worse. 1988. You spend your days following Julia around the house. You count the seconds between the 2 weekly visits from Daniel, the nurse. He suggests that Julia could live somewhere else, somewhere with 24-hour care, a home. It sits with you for a couple of months. You decide to move her into a full-time care facility. I would think that'd be the lesser evil of the two because I am no professional, and if I were to take care of her, I would probably just mess it up. So I just wanted to let you guys know that I was not trying to be selfish. I just wanted what was best for her. This game looks really nice. It is very pretty. Oh! It hurt us. Okay, good. Her family agrees with your decision. You find a fantastic place in Boulder and move her there. You see her every day, then every other day. You go out to the bar with your old friends. It's not the same. You get the feeling that every wife tells her husband, "If you ever put me in a home like Henry did, I will cut your balls off." You slowly decide not to see much of your old friends that much. Probably from fear of their wives. 1989. Julia's sister Susan moves to Boulder to be close to her. She visits her every day. You go with her some of the time. Susan buys you an old typewriter, urges you to use it if you won't see a therapist. You won't. You've always really liked Susan. Thank you, Susan. I will write my memoirs on this typewriter. Months go by, mayhem dies. Julia doesn't remember him when you tell her. It's even sadder. Sometimes it takes her a minute to lock in on you. In the back of your mind, you believe it's because you see her less and less. And seeing her less and less makes her forget you more, you think. Summer is coming, and you see an ad in the paper for a job. Oh my God. His life is just going downhill. Nothing good is happening. You take it. This might be a good thing. Get away from everything, just forget about your problems. don't run away from them. Just, you know, take some time for yourself. I agree with your decision, Henry. Take a job in the Wyoming wilderness as a fire lookout. Yeah. This is a place you can really be alone and just think. This would be a cool job. I would take a job like this. I'd, of course, bring something to play with. Like a PlayStation Portable, an Xbox One, a PC. I better have internet connection. But if not, that's okay. I'll be doing local recordings like I am now and just upload it after the job is over. So, looks like we just arrived at this lookout tower. And we are to turn on the power. Windows are boarded up and everything.
Hello, Two Forks Tower.
Hello? Yes? Hello?
Two Forks Tower, this is Thoroughfare Tower. Come in.
Contact supervisor on radio. It's a radio. Oh.
I know you're there. Your lights are on.
No, they're not. I'm not here. I'm not here.
Hello, Two Forks, come back. Pick up your radio.
Okay, she knows we're here. I just wanted to go to sleep. I've been hiking for who knows how long. Hello?
Hello? Whoever this is?
It's Henry, right?
Yeah.
I'm Delilah.
Yeah, that's what the guy said on the phone.
So, what's wrong with you?
Excuse me?
People take this job to get away from something. So, what's wrong?
What's wrong with you?
She's a little forward.
That's a great idea. Go ahead.
Look, I just hiked for 2 days, so I don't really follow whatever it is you're doing right now.
You take a stab at what's wrong with me.
Fine, then can I sleep forever?
Sure, buddy. Okay, now go ahead.
You've killed 3 ex-husbands. You're rebelling against mom. Nobody back home can stand you. Oh my god. Henry needs some sleep. There's no way I'm saying any of that.
You're just gonna wait me out on this? Ugh, fine.
Okay, that's an option.
Take a second here and have a guess about you.
So if you don't want to say anything,
I don't know anything about you. But 9 times out of 10, folks out here simply got dumped.
Huh, is that it?
Close?
Good night.
Good night. Welcome to the job.
It looks like we are at Two Forks Tower. That's probably our fire lookout tower. I just saw some supply boxes that said supplies for Two Forks.
Good morning, Henry. Well, I guess good afternoon. You probably slept like a rock. Anyway, there's still a few hours of daylight to get some work in. I can see you at your desk, so call me when you're ready.
Hey, sorry. Guess I slept in.
You got a relaxing, what, 14 hours of sleep? Whew.
Wow.
Jesus, I guess it's what, 6?
6:45.
Whoops.
Where's the clock?
Don't worry about it. That hike puts everyone out of commission for a day or two.
But broken.
Now that you're up, let me quickly get you acquainted with the job. There's a thing in the middle of your room with a round map on it. Do you see it?
Yes.
Okay, yeah, I see it.
This is the Osborne Firefinder, invented in 1914 by W.B.
Osborne?
You use this to spot, you guessed it, what the fuck?
What is it?
Nothing. What? You use this to... Oh, fuck me!
Good God, language, lady.
Out your west-facing window. Are you seeing what I'm seeing?
Oh, look at that. Delilah's tower is right there.
Are those fucking fireworks?
My west-facing window. Where?
I need you to confirm. Do you see them?
I'm trying to say it.
Whoa. That's not legal, right?
No. You need to get down there right now and stop them. Fire danger is through the fucking roof.
Is that really my job?
Your job is whatever I say it is. Look, the closest ranger is like 2 days away. Go down there and set him straight.
Do I write him a ticket?
Easy there, Dirty Harry.
Well?
Get going. You'll probably need a rope to get down the shale between you and the lake, if I remember right.
Dirty Harry.
There should be one in the supply box on the way. The code is 1234.
Find rope box and NFS cash box 306. Ah, that's very convenient. Convenient.
Convenient.
That's one word for it.
Hey, I can see your tower.
Yep, that's me. Bye.
Hello. That's cool. You can just creep up on me whenever you want. That's nice. I don't have any binoculars. Can I look over there? Whatever. Time to go put a stop to this fireworks shenanigans. So fire danger is through the roof. As we saw on the way in. It was in red. I don't really know what red stood for. But usually red means a bad thing. So let's put a stop to this. Find rope in NFS cash box 306. Read my map. Okay. Zoom in. Two Forks Lookout. Cache 306. Okay, so we just have to keep following this trail and we'll end up at the cache. Oh, this is so cool. This foresty landscape. Just the sound of nature. It's so peaceful out here. This is so good for Henry. Perfect spot for him to unwind and just try to forget about his problems. Well, you know, not really forget about it, but get over it. No better place to do that but here. I always found that being by yourself really helps you out when you're overwhelmed. Just being by yourself in quiet, meditating, all those are good things.
I found the supply box.
Great.
That's all you had to say about it.
So are there a lot of these out in the woods?
Yeah, we got them all over the Shoshone. They saved us a lot of back and forth from the trailhead.
Shoshone.
Don't take all the good stuff.
Yeah, all right.
That's an incredible name.
Hey, what's Shoshone. The code again?
1234. A whole lot of them.
Sounds like a Native American tribe.
Hey, what's the code again?
1234. A whole lot of them.
Already said that. 1, 2, 3, and 4. Gotta get a note. Okay, here's a rope.
I tracked down that rope. It was right where you said.
Great. So you should be set to get down to the lake.
Is he gonna say every single thing that he does? It's gonna be one of those games. Okay. Copy map information. That wouldn't hurt. Let me just do that. Oh, hey.
People just stuff these things with old food? That's how you get bears.
Those boxes are bear proof. I wouldn't worry about it.
Bear proof. Okay, cool. But it's open now, so what do I do about this? I mean, it's been there for a while. It's not really a good idea to eat something that's been there. A granola bar, no less. Well, granola bars aren't that bad. Still, it's been there. And it's been in humidity and heat. I'm not taking it. There is a pine cone here. Don't know what to do with it. Oh. Can he not throw? Looks like he can only toss. Okay.
Do people lose their shit doing this job? There's a note that says a guy just left his post.
It happens, yeah. You're not gonna pop your top, are you, Henry?
I wasn't planning on it.
Nope. I'm here to rehabilitate. July 7th, 1986. Ron. Hey, man. Guy couldn't take it, so I locked up his lookout and put some stuff in the box. Found one of those bars you liked, hiking into the park, but let's get fucked when I'm back. Dave. There's a lot of swearing in this game. So, just as a disclaimer, I'm going to put something in the description about the amount of words, choice words, that they decided to put in the game. Okay, so we need to go to... where again? Forgot. Where are the fireworks? I'm gonna go this way. X to toggle jogging. Yes! Why not? Oh my gosh. This looks really incredible. This view.
This vista is incredible.
Yes.
Which one?
Down the hill from my tower. There's a canyon and then the rest of... well, everything.
Yeah, you should see what I'm looking at. An eagle has been hovering over this gorge for the past... hour? Maybe if you're good, you can come by and see it at the end of the summer.
I would love to, Delilah. Yes. That's awesome. Whoa, that sounded like a big one. Oh, they're having a lot of fun down there. I wish I was taking off into the woods and just shooting off fireworks. I know this sounds really bad, but I wouldn't mind doing that. That sounds like fun. Report claw marks.
Hey, there's a tree out here that's been ripped to hell.
And?
Don't you think that's, you know, like, disconcerting?
Henry, there are 500-pound grizzly bears out here. They sharpen their claws on trees.
We don't have grizzlies in Colorado. People killed them a long time ago.
Well, in the thoroughfare, they hunt people, they kill people, they bury their bodies, and then come back weeks later to eat them because they prefer rotten meat. People just disappear.
Don't you think that's disconcerting?
No, Henry, that's life.
Christ, lady.
She is something else. Very brutal. But she's been in a Shoshone, or whatever this place is called, for quite a while now. Assuming so, because she's my supervisor. And I think we found a shale slide she was talking about. This looks pretty steep, though. Can I say something about this? I can.
This shale slide is steep. How do you expect me to get down this?
I don't remember it being that bad. It's not even named on our topos.
It's not named? Should be.
Yeah, well, I go with Widowmaker.
Come on, it's really not that bad.
It's actually a pretty good name.
It's a 50-foot cliff made of rocks that look like knives.
They just look like knives, okay? Plus, there's already a Widowmaker on the backside of Carter Mountain. It would be confusing.
What, really? I just updated my map. I wonder if it actually named it Widowmaker. Oh my god, it actually did. Oh, that's so awesome. So whatever you choose actually affects what happens in the game. I gotta be careful about my choices. How do I get down?
How do you expect me to get down this?
Well, did you get that rope?
Yeah, I got it.
Okay, just lash it to something nearby and take it slow.
Here goes nothing. Don't fail me now, old rope. Oh, it just got dark.
No, no, no!
Oh my god. Oh my god. Did I break something? That was a long drop. Holy crap. Oh, how am I gonna get back up? I'm still moving, so I'm okay.
Hey.
What the hell's wrong with you?
Oh, ouch.
The best of me.
What exactly happened?
My rope snapped coming down the shale slide.
You didn't break anything, did you?
No, I think I'll make it.
Well, be careful for Christ's sake.
Okay, so I'm assuming the people blowing off the fireworks hurt us, because as soon as we landed and screamed for our lives, the fireworks went away. Coincidence? I think not. Oh, it could be. Whatever. Let's check the map. We're still on the right path here. There's another one of these.
Hey, there's a tie-off point off here, just a little way from the shale slide.
Oh, you ready to get back on that horse, huh?
Well, I can't go any further, is what I'm saying.
That heads south down to the creek, but you should be able to get to the lake just by continuing west. Without any, you know, mountaineering.
All right.
It's a long summer. You can explore later.
Cool. I'm glad we're going to take the time to explore, because yeah, this place is beautiful. It's so cool. Wilderness ahoy. Although, I wonder why he didn't take a dirt bike or some kind of off-roading vehicle with him. You know, that truck, that pickup truck, was big enough to put a dirt bike in the back of. Just saying, it would have saved him 2 days of hiking. And possibly all this walking. That could just be me, though. But it is nice.
Wow, there's a big rock outcropping down here near the lake. It's really something.
Yeah, I don't want to ruin
camping. There used to be a group of guys who would boulder out there a couple times a year.
What happened to
the them? Terrain?
You know, stop coming out.
Heading west. We're not heading west anymore. I don't know where I'm at. Oh, what's that? Hey, buddy.
There's a critter out here. A raccoon.
I can't understand you.
What's he got there?
Because I'm whispering.
Because you're whispering.
Crap. I stepped on a twig. I was trying to see what the raccoon had. Can I see it? What did the raccoon have? Trying to break a nut or something, like a squirrel, but then that would make no sense. Well, it is wildlife, whatever. It just wouldn't be the typical thing to do. Oh, what the heck? Come on. I see trash.
Finding a bunch of empty beer cans. They threw them all over hell.
The idiots down at the lake?
Yeah, them. I just found where they're hanging out.
Them? The idiots? So we're assuming it's more than one person.
What do you know? People with shitty manners drink shitty beer.
What, you don't like a cold Musqua Light on a hot day?
No, I do. But then again, I didn't say my manners were any good. Better than these fucking litter bugs, though, that's for sure.
I'm gonna clean up all of it. I'm gonna clean up every single one of you. Oh, that sounded like had something in it. There's so many of these. But I am the maid. There is no maid in the forest. I don't think they're gonna clean up their own things. I mean, they just threw it all over the place. I hear loud music. It's pretty bumpin'. It's pretty bumpin' music.
We left half a bottle of whiskey. Decent stuff.
Drunk pyromaniacs. Fucking great.
Found the fireworks. They didn't even try to hide them.
Well, confiscate them.
Why?
Oh shit. Ferreter Irish.
Ferreter Irish. What is that? I don't drink alcohol, so I don't even know what it is. It's single malt whiskey. Save for later. Okay. I'm confiscating this too. As reparation for you littering the forest. I'm confiscating this too, in hopes that I can set it off later.
Well, I put out their fire.
Man, I would have named that forest fire something good, too.
Hey, I can always restart it.
No. I think your first instinct was the right one.
I mean, it's not like it's anywhere that's too near to anything flammable, except for this patch of grass right here. I could have put it down over here a little bit more, then they would have been okay.
They left their packs tied up here.
Don't fuck with them. The last thing we need is some hikers filing a report about harassment.
I just want a sneak peek. They really like the color orange in this game.
Well, they left their clothes out to dry. It looks like two people. Well, what if they're naked?
Won't that be exciting? Look, they're obviously still there, so tell them off and then head back.
Okay. Block trail. Oh, what is that? There's got to be like some kind of noise ordinance, even in the forest. I mean, they could be attracting wildlife or worse, people.
I found a bra.
A nudie pyromaniac. Remain professional.
Examine? What am I going to examine about it? Yeah, that's a bra. What did I just do with it? Oh my god. Dude, put it back up there. What the heck? I would just leave it there, man. Well, at least it's matching.
There are, panties.
What?
I don't want to say that word again.
Why, because you're 12?
Panties?
There's a... Ooh.
Yes?
There are two naked ladies out here.
Can you handle that?
Come on, I like naked ladies same as anyone, but there's, you know...
Two?
Yeah.
I know this will be tough for you, but try to pick your tongue up off the ground and do your job.
Okay.
Okay.
Found them in the lake.
Skinny dipping?
Yeah.
Is that a guy over there?
Oh boy.
Sorry, ladies, I'm not looking. I just wanted to come out here and talk with you. Hello? Excuse me. Hi. Would you guys mind keeping it down and turning the fireworks off? Please stop lighting fireworks. Can I say something? Come on. Maybe I'll be able to pick up the boombox.
Cool stereo!
Cool stereo.
Seriously, it was expensive.
Fucking cool it with the fireworks.
Please just put it down. We won't light anymore. You probably have a tiny dick.
Chelsea,
it's my boombox.
It's messed up. Be cool. I'm not looking at you.
You're just a sad man out of the woods.
Are they gone? They're gone. Fine. I'm keeping this. Trail sign. Find a way back to Two Forks Lookout. Well, here's one.
It went fine.
Oh, wow. The music's a little loud.
Oh, sorry. I took their stereo.
Okay, well, I guess we're all leaving then?
Yeah, I think so.
But seriously, though, thanks for dealing with it.
All right, now we got some tunes. I could like turn this down a little bit. Okay. I was about to say he might have dropped that stereo, but it looks like he puts it away for a second and it's still in his hand. Cool. Dude. If they say at some point that I'm a thief, I'll be like, I'm sorry, I confiscated it. Noise ordinance. It attracts wildlife and crap. But now at least we have some entertainment while we're here.
I have a bit of a confession to make.
What is it?
Look, I was drunk last night when I welcomed you to the job.
Yeah, well, you're not the first boss to be guilty of that.
I know I can get a little pushy, you know, putting you on the spot about why you're out here and stuff. I'll keep that sort of thing to a minimum.
Make sure you guys are reading the subtitles. It's kind of a little hard to hear.
Hey, I can see my tower. How do I get back?
If it's the one I think it is, there should be an old trail the Forest Service closed off a couple years back.
And I'm sure their reasons for closing it off had nothing to do with safety, right?
Oh, it washed out and became a fucking death trap.
Oh.
So, you know, be careful.
Well, thank you.
So there's no noise ordinances or rules out here?
No. But that music I hear makes a good case for them.
Yeah, no kidding.
Can I still take out my compass while I have this? So our tower's toward the southeast. Wait, there's something on the back of that. I wonder if that says I love music or something. I hope this isn't copyrighted music. That would be bad. I want to be able to upload this on YouTube. Whoa.
Hey, I heard some thunder.
Yeah, I've got eyes on a storm out to the north.
Well, that's bad, right? Because of the lightning?
It just means we'll be busy. Hurry home.
Run.
Try not to get hit by lightning.
I'm hurrying home.
Yeah, I'm not sure I got a lot of choice in getting struck down.
Especially not with your electric personality.
Ha ha ha!
I see my joke did not spark your sense of humor.
Oh, I'm just gonna let her have that one.
She's got jokes. Okay, we found our second cache here. 303, I think it said. 3, 4. Copy this map information. What did it update? Probably updated somewhere up here. Let's put this away. To Beartooth Point, Thunder Canyon, Two Forks Lookout. Thunder Canyon. Okay, that's where I'm at. Two Forks Lookout is this way, so we're going the right way. Okay. There's a flashlight in here. Cool.
Ah!
Oh, God. That was blinding. Sorry. What do I do with this? It's cool and all, but what do I do with it?
Yeah, I get the sense that not everything in here is useful.
In the boxes? Why's that?
I don't really know what I'll do with the deer horn.
Firstly, they're called antlers. And secondly, stay out here long enough and you'll get creative.
Whoa, what is this?
What's in this cave down here?
In Thunder Canyon.
Thunder Canyon?
Hey, I didn't name it. But in the cave, I don't know, rocks? NFS tells people not to go too far in there. It's pretty dangerous.
Oh, it'd be cool to have the boombox in there.
So I say, fuck it.
Echo effect.
You can go where you want.
Great. I used to go camping with someone back in Colorado.
Let's do it.
Might be great to explore it sometime this summer.
Well, that could be fun. Obviously, be very careful.
I'm exploring it right now.
It doesn't seem that dangerous.
Whoa, whoa! Ah, no!
Henry!
Seriously, it's completely fine in here.
God damn it.
Damn, Henry. What the hell was that?
It looks like the path leads through the cave.
Back in the cave, huh? Man, I don't need to lose another lookout in there.
What?
Another lookout?
They always
lose a lookout.
They never come out.
Ah, so this is another one of your jokes.
Yeah, it is. Yep.
There's a locked gate in here.
This cave is gated off.
It's to stop spelunkers from dying without getting the keys from the Forest Service office first.
Sense.
Although, Debbie says she lost them like 3 years ago, so maybe its mysteries are locked away for good.
A skeleton key?
Yeah, but maybe you can find another one to get your caving kicks in.
Oh, this one's so close to home and convenient, though.
Aw, sorry, Hank.
Where does that go? And who's Hank? Did you just call us Hank? Oh, we might actually be going the right way here. Okay, yeah. We're making so much noise out here. So much noise. Oh, hi.
There's some guy out here giving me the creeps.
The creeps? Wait, he's looking at you? Is he doing anything else?
I don't think so.
Henry, there's something something someone should have told you about this area.
What is it?
It's outside.
Come on.
The whole thing. People come and go as they please. It's madness.
Yeah, okay, I get it.
Bumping into someone in the middle of nowhere is part of the fun.
Okay, so I think that mysterious figure was over yonder. Can we turn this boombox off? I'm pretty impressed with Henry being able to climb all these rocks and jump over bridges and everything. With the boombox in hand. That's pretty impressive. I'm glad we have music to pass time. Mantle. I'm starting to know the lyrics of this song. Probably a song called Push Play. Hop over. What's over here? Where'd that dude go? There's nothing over here. Come on, we're almost there, man. What just happened? Well, that trail's not closed anymore.
Well, that trail isn't closed anymore.
Yes, that's what I just said.
I took care of the blocked path. It was backbreaking, but, you know, anything for the service.
Well, thank you.
Anytime.
We're home, yes. We are so home. Oh. What the hell?
What can I do for you?
Well, my typewriter is on the ground, outside of my tower.
You right?
What happened to you, Flemington?
Wind? No. How the hell?
You should get inside.
Fuck me.
I'm taking the radio with me just in case somebody's up there. Then they'll know I'm coming. Better hide, or get ready to be knocked out by this awesome 80s music. Okay, nobody's there. Oh, jeez. Okay, there's broken glass and everything.
Someone broke in.
Hey, what?
They wrecked the place. Threw my typewriter out the window. Motherfucker.
Holy shit. I'll let the Forest Service know what happened.
Let's put this back. I'm going to have to what? What'd I say? Going to have to fix this window.
Gonna have to fix the window.
Okay, I put in a call.
Thank you.
Okay, thanks.
Do you have any idea who would have done this?
Maybe that guy I saw in the canyon, but I don't know why the fuck he'd want to mess with my stuff.
Well, I'll have to keep an eye out for a man hiking on his own and question him if they find him. I can't believe someone would do this. I worry about bears and fires, and that's about it. And now I've got to worry about some deranged hiker going after lookouts? Great. Okay, in the morning I'm gonna call my friend Patty, who works the desk down in Cody. They keep a list of everyone who's officially been in and out of the trailhead since, I don't know, forever, and see if we can get a list of names. Won't get much, but at least if anything else happens, we can refer to it and see if anything comes up.
Thanks.
Man, what happened here?
Well, I sure don't know.
You will. I promise.
Probably don't.
Wait, what? Was he saying something?
We don't need this in my life right now.
Wake up! Hey, wake up!
What is going on? What happened to the boombox? What happened to the boombox? Where is my pillow? And where? I feel like I'm missing stuff. Did it finally turn off the boombox? I don't know where it is, though. Did I just, like, throw it out the window because I couldn't stand the music anymore? I have no clue. But I'm just looking around to see if I'm missing anything else. I didn't actually get a chance to look around very well. So, let's look around some more. Twenty-sided die, old paper. Why was there a, Oh! Escape from two orcs. This is like a map of the Shoshone. Of the Two Forks area. Escape from two orcs? Oh, that's clever. That's very clever. I wonder if the things in here are actual places. you know, just with messed up names. Okay, I'll take a look at you later. If I can put you back in there properly. I guess I can't. Sleep is going to be a real problem without making this a list of all the happenings all the time for Henry for the future. There's got to be a better way to actually read that. Going to have to figure out today because last night wasn't good and I'm fucking freezing. I was 100% sure I wouldn't have any Jules dress dreams out here since I was sleeping in a new place and everything, but sure enough, during the 30 minutes I fell asleep around 5 a.m., there we were back on the beach in Melbourne. There's that moment where I know it's coming, where I know the water is gonna come up and up and up, and I think I'm gonna spew, or my heart is going to stop, or something, but this time I woke up before anything happened. Maybe that's progress. I had my fingers crossed that I would just be dreaming about squirrels and mountains and trees and shit, but what are you going to do? Okay. I'm going to need to remember to read that every day if he's doing his job of writing his memoirs every day. Oh, I can throw things. Oh, I just learned how to throw things. You just have to hold it and release. Okay, that's good. You will just... Oh, what the heck? Put back. Oh, you can actually put this back somewhere? Can I put it back over here? This belongs here, apparently. Okay. Yeah, it's a good spot for that. Except I don't like this glass cleaner being here. Can I put it back here somewhere? Oh, boy. I'm HGTVing the hell out of this place. I don't want a pine cone in here. What am I going to do with that? Let's put the glass cleaner up there. Okay, I can't. Okay, I guess I got to put it back here. Oh, God. What the heck? There we go. Okay, so I found where the two orcs map is supposed to go. Death strikes at two. I put everything back there. Alrighty then, this is where we're going to end episode 1 of Firewatch. Keep it locked here at the Power Grid if you want to see more. Episode 2, here we go. So, let's recap what happened in day 1. Wow. So first of all, we hiked about 2 days to get to our lookout tower. We finally met our boss supervisor, Delilah. Not in person, per se, but, you know, through the radio, and we're just going to believe that she is our supervisor. Nothing wrong with that. What else happened? We found 2 girls who were skinny dipping in the lake and also shooting off fireworks, which was a huge no-no. So Delilah, our boss, our supposed boss, told us to go down there and stop it. So I confiscated their fireworks, confiscated their boombox, confiscated... What else did I confiscate? Their whiskey. And now they're gone, so I don't know where they went. But other than that, everything is honky-dory. Not really, because there was a mysterious figure that shined their flashlight right in our face. And then when we got back to our lookout tower, it was trashed. Somebody had broken in and threw the typewriter out, stole our sheets and our pillow, and I don't know what else. So, don't know what I'm going to be sleeping on now. Probably my backpack or something as my pillow. But anyway, thank you all so much for watching. Make sure you guys leave a comment down below. Let me know what you think of the story so far. Anything you can think of. What do you think is going to happen next? Who do you think broke into the tower and threw that typewriter out the window? What the hell were those girls doing out there, and why did they drink so much beer? Once again, thank you all so much for watching. My name is Suleet. Leave a thumbs up if you liked it, and I will see you later here at the Power Grid. Bye!